Matthew had a bad spell with his heart Thursday, Marilla explained, and I didn't feel like leaving him. Oh, yes, he's all right again now, but he takes them spells oftener than he used to, and I'm anxious about him. The doctor says he must be careful to avoid excitement. That's easy enough, for Matthew doesn't go about looking for excitement by any means, and never did. But he's not to do any heavy work, either, and you might as well tell Matthew not to breathe as not to work. Come and lay off your things, Rachel. You'll stay to tea? Well, seeing you're so pressing, perhaps I might as well stay, said Mrs. Rachel, who had not the slightest intention of doing anything else. Mrs. Rachel and Marilla sat comfortably in the parlor while Anne got the tea and made hot biscuits that were light and white enough to defy even Mrs. Rachel's criticism. I must say Anne has turned out a real smart girl, admitted Mrs. Rachel as Marilla accompanied her to the end of the lane at sunset. She must be a great help to you. She is, said Marilla, and she's real steady and reliable now. I used to be afraid she'd never get over her feather-brained ways, but she has, and I wouldn't be afraid to trust her in anything now. I never would have thought she'd have turned out so well that first day I was here 3 years ago, said Mrs. Rachel. Lawful heart, shall I ever forget that tantrum of hers. When I went home that night, I says to Thomas, says I, "Mark my words, Thomas, Marilla Cuthbert'll live to rue the step she's took." But I was mistaken, and I'm real glad of it. I ain't one of those kind of people, Marilla, as can never be brought to own up that they've made a mistake. Nope, that never was my way, thank goodness. I did make a mistake in judging Anne. But it weren't no wonder, for an odder, unexpected, or witch of a child there never was in this world, that's what. There was no cipherin' her out by the rules that worked with other children. It's nothing short of wonderful how she's improved these 3 years, but especially in looks. She's a real pretty girl got to be, though I can't say I'm overly partial to that pale, big-eyed style myself. I like more snap and color, like Diana Barry has, or Ruby Gillis. Ruby Gillis's looks are real showy. But somehow, I don't know how it is, but when Anne and them are together, though she ain't half as handsome, she makes them look kind of common and overdone. Something like them white June lilies she calls Narcissus alongside the big red peonies, that's what.